हेलो क्लास 10। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर 1 ऑफ सिविक्स द यूनियन पार्लियामेंट। टुडेज टॉपिक इज पावर्स एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट। वी विल डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स। सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडेज टॉपिक इज लेजिस्लेटिव पावर्स, कंट्रोल ओवर द एग्जीक्यूटिव, जुडिशियल फंक्शंस और जुडिशियल पावर्स, कंट्रोल ओवर द फाइनेंस ऑफ द कंट्री, इलेक्टोरल फंक्शंस। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस द कीवर्ड्स। नंबर 1 अमेंड्स, इट मीन्स चेंज। नंबर 2 प्रोक्लेम्ड, इट मीन्स शोन। नंबर 3 रेटिफाइड, इट मीन्स सेंक्शनड। नंबर 4 प्रोक्लामेशन, इट मीन्स ऑर्डर। नंबर 5 कंडेम, इट मीन्स क्रिटिसाइज। नंबर 6 डेफामेशन, इट मीन्स अब्यूज। नंबर 7 रेप्रीमेंडेड, इट मीन्स क्रिटिसाइज। नंबर 8 प्रॉपर्टी, इट मीन्स एप्रोप्रिएटनेस। पावर्स एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट। ऑल्दो द प्राइमरी फंक्शन ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट इज लेजिस्लेशन, आर पार्लियामेंट हैज़ टू परफॉर्म अ सीरीज ऑफ अदर फंक्शंस टू। द मेन ड्यूटीज ऑफ द इंडियन पार्लियामेंट कैन बी डिस्कस्ड अंडर द फॉलोइंग 5 हेड्स। लेजिस्लेटिव पावर्स, control over the executive, judicial functions, control over the finance of the country, electoral functions. The main function of the parliament is to make laws, acting on behalf of voters and citizens, examining the government and the formation of government. The main powers and functions we will discuss under the following heads: legislative powers, control over executive, judicial functions, control over the finance of the country, electoral functions. First, legislative powers. The parliament is the law-making body at the central level. It frames new laws and amends. Amends mean change, or repeals means cancel them, if necessary, on all the 97 subjects of the union list and all the residuary subjects which have not found a place in any of the lists. The legislative powers of the federal government lie within the Parliament of India. Thus, the laws that are framed by the Parliament of India are enforced throughout the country. There are many subjects in our constitution and they are divided among the state, union and concurrent list. Parliament has the power to amend or repeal subjects of the union list and all residuary subjects. As far as the 47 subjects in the concurrent list are concerned, both the parliament and the state legislatures have got the right to make laws. But if any state laws come into conflict with the central law shall prevail. 47 subjects are included in concurrent list, and both parliament and the state legislature have got the right to make laws. In case of a conflict between the central and the state law on a subject included in concurrent list, the central law prevails over the state law. If the state law has been reserved for the consideration of the president and have received his approval, then the state law prevails in that state. C point. It can enact. Enact means pass laws on the 61 subjects of the state list. Also, if the Rajya Sabha passes a resolution with a 2/3 majority to the effect that the particular subject of the state list has come to assume national importance, two or more states request the center to pass a law for them on one or more subjects mutually agreed upon by them, a state of national emergency is proclaimed. Proclaimed means shown by the president. President takes over the administration of a state on the breakdown of the constitutional machinery in the state. Such laws will concern only the states for which they are passed. The parliament has also the power to make laws on 61 subjects of the state list. If, when the Rajya Sabha passes a resolution act, if it is required by two or more states to request the parliament, when the national emergency is under operation, when the constitutional machinery of a state breaks down, means any state fails to comply with or to give effect to the direction given by union government, and rule of the presidents under operation. Also, when it is important to give recognition to international treaties, arguments and conventions. The Union Parliament has the sole right to amend the Constitution, although in certain cases these amendments should also be ratified. Ratified means sanctioned by a majority of the states. The states can in no case initiate an amendment to the Constitution. Only the Parliament of India has right to make changes in the Constitution without the consent of the state legislatures. States do not have even the right to propose amendments. In some cases like fundamental rights and directive principles are two most important provisions that can be amended by special majority. E. The Parliament can make laws on residuary subjects. Residuary subjects are those subjects which are not present in any list mentioned in the Constitution, like computer software, e-commerce, etc. These subjects came into being after the Constitution was created. Parliament can make laws on these subjects. All ordinances means law issued by the President, must be approved by Parliament within 6 weeks after its session has begun, failing which an ordinance lapses. President can issue ordinance when one of the House of the Parliament is not in session. The maximum validity of ordinance is 6 weeks. Ordinance will expire after 6 weeks once both House of the Parliament are in session. Emergency proclamation. Proclamation means order made by the President must be approved by Parliament. A proclamation of emergency declaring that the security of India or any part of the territory is threatened by war or by external aggression. The state of emergency made by the President must be approved by the Parliament. Point 2. Control over executive. The government is directly responsible to the Parliament for its acts of omission and commission. The members of the government, that is the ministers, are chosen from among the members of the majority party in the Parliament, and they hold office only till they enjoy the confidence of the Parliament. To be more precise means exact that of the Lok Sabha. The Parliament in this way is a controlling body of the government. It exercises this control through different ways as are given below. Two ways through which Parliament controls the executive are: the Parliament keeps a day-to-day watch over the activities of the executive. As ours is a parliamentary system of government, the executive is responsible to the Parliament for all acts of omission and commissions. Question R. An hour a day in the daily routine of the Parliament when in session is reserved for making questions from the government. The members can ask any question relating to the administration and policies, and the ministers are obliged to answer them. Question hour is the first hour of a sitting session of India's Lok Sabha devoted to question that members of Parliament raise about any aspect of administrative activity. The concerned minister is obliged to answer to the Parliament either orally or in writing, depending on the type of questions raised. Vote of no confidence. If a government floats the Constitution and acts in contravention of the provision thereof, the government can be voted out of office by passing a vote of no confidence against the Prime Minister or the ministry as a whole or any of its members. In such a case, the whole ministry has to resign. In Parliament, the Council of Ministers work till it enjoys the confidence of the legislature. If an individual minister loses the confidence vote, he or she must resign. If the Prime Minister loses the no confidence vote, his or her entire government has to resign. It is a trustworthy instrument to make government responsible. Other motions of censure. The Parliament can exercise its control over the government by a number of other motions also, which if passed amount to no confidence. They include adjournment motions, motions of censure against a minister or ministers, rejection of a government bill, passing of a private member's bill against the wishes of the government, etc. The parliament can control over the government by a number of other motions, like adjournment motion, motion of censure against the ministers, passing of private bill or rejection of a government bill, etc. Monetary controls. The parliament can hold the strings. Strings means thread of the government tied by voting a cut in the annual or supplementary budget or a cut in the salaries of the ministers in the face of opposition from the treasury benches. It also appoints the Public Accounts Committee to examine the mode of government expenditure. The Comptroller and Auditor General of India acts as its financial advisor. It is not enough that Parliament must grant the money to the executive for expenditure and vote the taxes. It also has to see that the appropriations for funds are spent on the items approved in a wise and economical manner. To ensure proper expenditure and receipts, the Parliament provides for accounting and audit. In India, for the purpose of accounting and audit, the Office of Comptroller and Auditor General has been set up. The Parliament has also set up the Public Accounts Committee, the Estimates Committee, and the Committee on Public Undertakings. The Parliament can cut in the annual or supplementary budget or salaries of the minister from treasury benches. Judicial functions or judicial powers. There is no denying the fact that the parliament is mainly a legislative body, but it enjoys certain judicial powers as well. Some of them are narrated below. A. It can impeach the president for any violation of the constitution. Charges can be framed by either of the house, two houses of parliament, by a two-third majority. If the charges are established by the other house by the same majority, the president stands impeached and he is at once removed from his office. No doubt, parliament is mainly a legislative body, but it is also enjoys judicial powers. If the president, vice president, breaks any law against the constitution, then they can be impeached or removed by the parliament. The president can be removed from office by a two-third majority in parliament. The parliament has the right to remove the judges of the Supreme Court and the High Courts, the Chief Election Commissioner and the Comptroller and Auditor General of India, if they are found guilty of violating any clause of the constitution. For this purpose, the motion can be moved if supported by one-fourth of members of either house and carried only if two-third members of each house vote in favor of the motion. Judges of the Supreme Court, High Court, Chief Election Commissioner, the Comptroller and Auditor General of India can be removed from their office, which requires a resolution passed by the Parliament of India, a two-third majority in both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha on the grounds of proved misbehavior or incapacity. Parliament can condemn, means criticize, any person if he is found guilty of defamation. Defamation means abuse, and contempt means disrespect of either house of the parliament. In 1961, the parliament reprimanded, means criticized, the editor of Blitz for bringing a member of the parliament to contempt and ridicule. If any member found abusing or violation of either house of the parliament, then parliament can criticize that person. In 1961, Blitz editor R. K. Karanjia was summoned to the bar of the house and criticized. His weekly news magazine was held guilty of disrespect for captioning a photograph of a Lok Sabha member of parliament, J.B. Kriplani, as Kripa Looney. Control over the finance of the country. The Union Parliament is the custodian, means guardian, of the national purse, neither a pie can be spent on any item, nor a paisa can be collected by way of taxes without the prior approval of the parliament. The Union Parliament is considered as the guardian, as it is the primary and the most often the exclusive arbiter of the federal fiscal affairs. Annual budget. The statement of the sources of income and the items of expenditure for the coming year, popularly called the budget, is presented in the Parliament by the Union Minister for Finance with the prior approval of the President. The Parliament is empowered to vote a cut in the budget or to reject it as a whole. A budget is defined as a plan or estimate of the amount of money needed for the cost of living or to be used for a specific purpose. This is presented by the Union Finance Minister with the prior approval of President. At present, Nirmala Sitharaman is our Finance Minister. Once the budget is prepared, it goes to the Parliament for enactment and legislation. The Parliament has full power to vote a cut in the budget or to reject as a whole. Consolidated Fund of India. Some items of the budget are charged from the Consolidated Fund of India. The Parliament has the right to debate the propriety, means appropriateness, of these items, but it cannot vote on them. The Consolidated Fund of India includes revenues which are received by the government through taxes and expenses incurred in the form of borrowings and loans. The budget consists of two types of expenditure: the expenditure charged upon the Consolidated Fund of India and the expenditure made from the Consolidated Fund of India. The charge expenditure is non-votable by the Parliament. It can only be discussed by the Parliament. Supplementary demands. The finance minister may come out with some supplementary demands in the later half of the financial year. Such demands are called the supplementary budget and are treated by the parliament just as the annual budget. A supplementary demand is an additional grant to meet government expenditure outside the annual budget. After presenting the union budget, the finance minister seeks approval from Parliament through supplementary demands for grants for additional expenditure above the budget estimate. Money for additional expenditure is sourced either from the savings of various ministries, departments, or revenue generations. Salary and allowances of the members of Parliament. It is the privilege of the Parliament to decide the salaries and allowances of its own members and also those of the ministers and the Chief Justice and judges of the Supreme Court and the High Courts. But this is to be borne in mind that in all financial matters, it is the Lok Sabha which has the real power. The Rajya Sabha has little power in this regard. The salary, allowances and pensions of the members of the Lok Sabha is governed by the members of Parliament. The Constitution of India provides that the members of either House of Parliament shall be entitled to receive such salaries and allowances as may from time to time be determined by Parliament, and also decides the salaries of Chief Justice, judges of Supreme Court and High Court. In all financial matters, Lok Sabha has more powers than the Rajya Sabha. Electoral functions. The Indian Parliament has to perform certain electoral duties as well, such as the Parliament of India, along with the Vidhan Sabha, legislative assemblies, elect the President of India. The Vice President of India is elected by both the Houses of the Parliament. The Lok Sabha elects its own Speaker and Deputy Speaker. Deputy Speaker from among its own members, while the Rajya Sabha elect its Deputy Chairman only. The electoral functions of the Parliament are: the President of India is selected by the Parliament along with the state legislatures. Both Houses of Parliament elect the Vice President of India. The Lok Sabha elects its Speaker and Deputy Speaker from among its own members. The Rajya Sabha has the right to elect its deputy chairman from its members. The laws to regulate the conduct of elections in the country are also made by the Parliament. Thank you. थैंक यू।